for getting education. And the teachers are depending on you for getting the salary, correct, no? So there is a mutual dependence. But above both of you, there is a principal of the school and owner of the college, without whose presence the school or college cannot run. You take plans for, you take oxygen we get from the plants, we supply them, carbon dioxide. If there is a mutual dependence, these two should have some absolute dependence in someone beyond. Otherwise, the mutual dependence symbiotic relationship cannot function. Like you can see a cow or a bull has got some, what do you call it, ticks they call it. And a bird sits and removes that on the neck and the animal doesn't fear. So the bird is helping the animal to remove the ticks from the neck, the germs, but the bird also gets its food also along with that. So there's a mutual dependence between the two, but someone has arranged that mutual dependence. So there must be someone above, just like in a school there is a principal, in a college there is a, similarly in a country there is a prime minister, similarly in mutual dependence, wherever it is there has to be somebody beyond. And source of life and its symptoms. See, when I say life, I will define it very scientifically. There are external symptoms of life. There are internal symptoms of life. Think about what I am going to say now. External symptoms are three. You can see that. For example, there is perception. Do you all agree that you are perceiving the world around you with your eyes, with your ears, with your nose, with your tongue and skin? Correct? You are perceiving. For example, you are walking in the road. You see a snake. Immediately, after that perception happens, mental ability. Mental ability means what? To think, to feel and will, to desire. Think means you think, oh, what is this? This is a snake. And what do you feel? Oh, snakes bite. And if they bite, what will happen? One may die also. Then immediately a desire arises in you. What is the desire? I want to escape from the snake now. Isn't it? That is called mental ability. These three things, thinking, feeling, willing. And then there is a purposeful action. And what is the purposeful? This is the third thing. Perception, mental ability, purposeful action. Immediately look for a stick, take a stick and beat the snake. That is purposeful action. Correct? Another example I'll tell you. See, somebody brings and keeps a gulab jamun floating in a golden liquid in a vati, isn't it? So you have perception. What is the perception? You see it. Then it registers in the mind. Oh, gulab jamuns are generally very sweet. Isn't it? They are very soft, very nice. I have eaten it before. I would like to eat it now. Correct? No? And then you are waiting for the host to tell you, go ahead. And immediately you put your hand. That's purposeful action. Take it and put it in the mouth. So there is a perception, mental ability, purposeful action. These three things are external symptoms of life. You can see. You can observe it. And there are internal also. What is internal is knowledge and awareness. For example, do you all agree that you are seeking knowledge in this world? Otherwise, why did you go to school? Isn't it? Like even if you keep a plant in a dark room, the plant will go towards the sunlight. That is, experiment is proven. So, tamasoma jyotirgamaya. From darkness means ignorance. You try to come to knowledge. So we all are seeking knowledge, yeah. Another thing that we all are seeking is existence. We don't want to die. If you bow down and take a stone, even a dog will run away. If you clap the hands, all the birds will fly away. Because nobody wants to die in this world. Have you tried catching a fly? You try to catch a fly, it will escape because it doesn't want to die. Every one of you sitting here, think about it, we don't want to die. We all have jivitasha, desire to live. This is also internally we can say. Thirdly, we all are pleasure seeking by nature. We want to become happy. You all know what is job satisfaction, you say, correct? No? How many of you look for job satisfaction? Correct, in the work that you do, correct? No? We all want satisfaction to begin with. Eventually we want that satisfaction to become happiness. Eventually we want it to become bliss, or you know, it's unlimited happiness. We all are looking for it. So these three things are life symptoms internally. Awareness and knowledge, desire to exist, and desire for satisfaction. You can see that. Internally and externally, I told you three things: perception, mental ability, and purposeful action. These things you do not find in a dead matter. You do not find them. If a snake goes around this, you know, cot, I mean around the stool, nothing is going to happen. There is neither perception, nor purposeful action, nor mental ability. Dead matter is inert It doesn't have feelings. It doesn't have consciousness. Like I am wearing this chadar because it's very cold, so I will cover like this. When it becomes very hot, I will take it out like this. Correct? Because I have consciousness. I have feelings, which is not there with dead matter. You see that. Therefore, life and matter are two distinct things. In 1996, one scientist made a statement. He said, by 2000, I can vouch, he said, I'll make a humanoid, male and female humanoids, he said. Any of you can pick up one of the humanoids and marry, and you will have one very big special plus point, he said. You know what is it? If you marry a girl humanoid, whatever you say, she will obey. She will not rebel against you. Because she'll be a humanoid, you can operate her. Like that he said. And now 2000 is gone, 2018 is gone. And my friends, I can tell you, million years will go. You cannot make a human being who is fully endowed with these symptoms which I told you just now. Because he himself realized life symptoms which are seen in living forms cannot be brought in matter. Like for example, one time they showed in television, a robo doing aarti for Balaji, you know, ringing the bell. This any electronics engineer can design such a robo, you know, ringing the bell and rotating. It's basically in a microprocessor, you write a program, you know, the servo motors can move it, isn't it? It's not very easy to do. Even your computer in the morning, you can say, I love you very much, good morning, or whatever. It can say whatever you program it. And we know that it has no feelings, correct? No? But we all are looking for feelings and emotions. That is why whenever you call somebody, and there is one lady saying, so and so is not available here, please leave a message. When the dial tone comes, ting, you know, when you hear that, how many of you feel like beating your phone down? Correct, no? You know it is not life. There are no life symptoms there. It is a dead thing, programmed thing coming. Therefore, my dear friends, first of all, understand what is life, what is matter. Know the difference between the two. See here, the theory of evolution, as is currently prevalent, it teaches all these things, which I showed you, how it failed at each and every step we showed. But the Vedic worldview says, chemicals do not produce life. In fact, life produces chemicals. I told you the lemon tree example. And then where is the life symptoms coming? It is coming from a driver of the body called self-energy or the soul. The soul is the driver of the body, who is anti-material, who is... there is a mechanistic science, there is non-mechanistic science. Whatever I told you now is all based on non-mechanistic science. It is actually a spiritual science. Like one famous writer said, we are all not human beings having a spiritual experience. He said we are spiritual beings having a human experience. Sometimes you are a spiritual being, being having a dog experience or a cat experience. You may change. For example, if you ask a question to any of you, who are you? You may immediately say, what will be answered? He will tell you a name. But here is a Dr. Harry Monson from Illinois College. You see what he says. Most of the human body is water. He says, there is calcium, phosphate, potassium, sulfur, sodium, magnesium, copper and iodine. All these things are there. Does it sound like you? Are you these substances? Calcium. Can I call you? Oh, calcium, please come here. Phosphorus, come here. Iron, come here. This is what your body is made up of. Is it the essential stuff of your identity? Not only that, all these chemicals in your body put together costs only how much? ₹110. Imagine one of your friends is going in a Mercedes-Benz and he faces a terrible accident and he is fainted unconscious. All of you now tell me the answer to my question. Will you take your friend to the hospital, rush him there, or will you take Mercedes-Benz to the garage? Which one will you do first? Garage? Okay, how many of you will take Mercedes-Benz to garage? You pull out your friend's body and throw it in the side of the road and take the Mercedes to the garage. How many of you will do that? See, your friend's body is only 110 rupees. But Mercedes-Benz is how much? 25, 30 lakhs? How much it is? 25 lakhs it can start, correct, no? Yeah. So why do you leave behind a 25 lakh commodity in the road and you take 110 rupees commodity to the, you know, hospital? Why do you do that? So, because there is something beyond the chemicals in the body.